One, two, three. My baby don't mess around because she loves me so, and this I know for sure. Welcome, Bobcats, to another edition of From the Field to the Fans. I'm your host and sports editor here at the University Star, Otis Evergrande. And with me, I have my good buddy, Tyler Hammond. What's going on?
Dude, not too much, man. This is exciting. We're literally bringing it from the field to the fans today. So it's a good change.
Yeah, if you can't notice, we're not in our dark studio. We are at beautiful Bobcat Stadium right now. It's really nice outside. Reason why we're here is because we're going to talk a little football.
Yeah, they had the spring game. This past Saturday.
That's right, on Saturday. And then we're going to talk baseball, talk softball, and talk all Bobcat athletics. But before we get into all that great stuff, take one quick break and hear a word from our sponsors. Don't try to fight the feeling, because the thought alone is killing me right now.
We've done it. Since opening last fall, Vapor Essentials has provided San Marcos with the best in electronic cigarettes. Whether you're kicking the smoking habit or interested in the growing popularity of vaping, there's never been a better time to visit. Vaporize and customize with our ever-expanding inventory. All 100% authentic hardware from brands like Totally Wicked, Halo, and more. We also carry the best quality e-liquid by Texas Select Vapor, with nicotine ranges from 0 to 24. Try before you buy, or just kick back at our full-service vaping bar. Our friendly and experienced staff will help you with all your vaping needs. Whether you're new or a familiar face, we'll be happy to provide you with the highest quality of customer service. At Vapor Essentials, we are consumers for consumers. We are your e-cigarette store. Stop by at 1515 Aquarina Springs or call us today at 512-878-8869. 18 and older, we ID.
Hey Bobcats, Otis here. Let's take a minute to talk about the University Bookstore and Fan Shop. These on-campus stores take care of all your Texas State needs, from books and supplies to Bobcat apparel and gifts. And the more you shop, the more these stores can give back to the students and organizations of Texas State. You can find the bookstore at the LBJ Student Center and the Fan Shop at Bobcat Stadium. You can also check them out online at bookstore.txstate.edu. Be sure to mention From the Field to the Fans and the Fan Shop for a 10% discount.
Need cupcakes or cookies for your sweet tooth, or maybe a custom decorated cake for your sorority or fraternity celebration? Pennington's Cakes has you covered. Since 1962, Pennington's Cakes has been providing some of the best tasting desserts in Central Texas. We bake our cakes, cupcakes, and cookies fresh to order with quality ingredients and lots of love and care. No matter the order, Pennington's Cakes will rise to the occasion. Every one of our creations is artfully decorated and memorably presented. Get 10% off your purchase when you show your Texas State ID. We also offer free wedding cake consultations. We're conveniently located at 1662 South I-35, right next to Thad Ziegler Glass. Come by or call us today and join our family of satisfied customers. Our number is 512-396-4059. 512-396-4059.
All right, I have Coach Jeff Conway here, co-offensive coordinator and running backs coach. Coach, you guys just played your spring game on Saturday. Goal team wins 30-29. What did you like seeing from the offense and defensive side of the ball as well?
Well, the first thing I liked is that I was on the gold team, and that means we won. So that's a good deal. But there was a lot of offense in the game, and that's always a good thing when you're coaching offense. I think we made a lot of progress in the offense we were installing this spring. I think the one thing that was a big negative coming out of the spring game was the turnovers, which we had too many of those. You're hoping for zero, and both sides had too many. So those have got to be eliminated.
I know Coach Moran talked a little bit about that. You know, defense is always usually ahead of the curve, but you talked about the new offense that you're implementing in the system. How did you like the progression of seeing that with the quarterback and your running backs and Chris Nuttall, Robert Lowe, and Tim Gay?
You know, I think it gives us a big advantage. You know, each step we take every fall or every spring, every long section throughout the calendar year helps us, and we progress in this offense. With the ability to run option football and the ability to throw it, I think it's a huge advantage. And now us having the ability to go up tempo, I think just stresses the defense even more. It's the same plays, So the kids, there's no difference there. It's just a communication issue. And we worked out most of the kinks in the spring. There's a few things still that we've got to work in and work on in the summer. But I thought the kids, number one, the kids were enthused about it. That's a huge deal. They bought in right off the bat. And they realized it was hard work. It wasn't just you can't go out there and go up tempo and expect it to work. You have to apply the concepts and the communication. And they did that for the most part. There were a couple problems, but nothing that we can't overcome.
Coach, you're going to play Navy, Illinois, Tulsa. Then you have the conference, play Lafayette. You're going to play Arkansas State, play a Georgia Southern team that didn't complete a pass against Florida and still won. What are you looking at when you play the Sun Belt this year and the tough non-conference schedule?
Well, we're just glad we don't have to play the Chicago Bears by what the list that you just gave us. The non-conference will be very challenging, but we think we match up well. Arkansas Pine Bluff will be a team that we have not faced before. And then Navy rolling in here, we're very familiar with them. And we've got to put more points on the board offensively than we did 2 years ago against them. They're a very good football team that's unique. And that presents a different challenge. We're excited that we have an open week right before them. And then going to Navy and going to Tulsa will be great challenges. Tulsa was a little bit down last year, but they've traditionally been a good program the last 10 years. And then Illinois playing in the Big Ten will be a big challenge for us. Now, what this does is prepare us for the Sun Belt, which is an excellent league. We think we match up well in the Sun Belt. You know, the two teams that are returning that are kind of the giant killers are Lafayette and Arkansas State. And Lafayette's probably ahead at this point because they have some stability in their coaching staff, and I'm sure that means throughout their team. Arkansas State, brand new coaching staff, but you know, that's been their issue, brand new coaching staff the last 3 years, and it hasn't seemed to slow them down. I think it's a great opportunity for us that we're going to get to play them on non-Saturday games and on national TV, and we're as excited as can be to have that stage set for us.
Thank you so much, Coach. I really appreciate it.
You bet. Thank you.
Yeah, that was Coach Jeff Conway, co-offensive coordinator and the running backs coach for the Texas State football team. He said some interesting things. You know, he's liking the development of the team, you know, that gauntlet of a schedule They're going to have to play non-conference. But he said it should help them going into conference play, playing the big dogs like Arkansas State and Lafayette. Very, very insightful coach. And I think there's a lot to look forward to on the offensive side of the ball.
No, definitely. I'd say the biggest thing I took out of that interview is he was talking about the enthusiasm. You know, the guys are excited to do it. You know, so that, I feel like that's one of the biggest things for their success. If they're excited about it, you know, they're gonna play hard. You know, Coach was saying, you know, everything ran smoothly. He said there's a few tweaks, a few things they need to work out. But I think for this point in time, you know, both teams put up 30, one put up 29. So I mean, it's looking good and it's working.
Yeah, and he was excited too because you know, he was part of the goal team that won. You know, they won 30-29, 59 points in total. Two standouts that stood out to me was Chris Nuttall. I believe he had 12 carries for 115 yards,
two scores
twice.
Yeah.
Bradley Miller, 5 catches, 142 yards, I believe.
And two more scores.
Two more scores. So you know, I think there's definitely some playmakers there. We got to see Robert Lowe a little bit. Tim Gay, of course, never getting tackled as usual. Tyler Jones wasn't live, so he wasn't able to get hit, but he made some really good throws, and I thought that the progression of the offense with the new up-tempo that they're trying to run and implement, I thought was really good.
Yeah, I mean, I saw Miller had a crazy catch for it, like tipped off a couple guys and took it for 70-something yards. But yeah, one thing I was thinking about was who's going to replace Erickson? You know, Erickson was kind of that third down go-to guy, so I really think you know, with Bradley Miller being, you know, a big tight end, wide receiver, I think he might be that guy that's going to step up and make those crucial catches on third down, maybe be a good red zone target. So I think with him stepping up, I think it's going to really, really do a lot for this offense.
Yeah, there's two guys that stand out to me in particular. And I know one only got one target. It wasn't a very good throw. But Bryce Gunter, who was Tyler Jones' high school teammate at Stephenville when they won the 3A state championship, you know, I like to call him the man.
Yeah.
He is a man.
He
is 6'3", 6'4", 225, solid.
And he's only a freshman.
Yeah. He redshirted last year.
Yeah.
And I think he's going to do wonders. He's going to be a big red zone target. And Ben Aija, 6'3 guy. So Fran definitely knew what he was doing when he was recruiting big receivers. Yeah. Kind of replaced the little guys in Andy Erickson and Isaiah Battle a little bit. Replaced them with two bigger guys and Bradley Miller as well. he should be solid for them. But the running game is what I look to take advantage of. I think Robert Lowe, Chris Nuttall, and Tim Gay, the trio on the backfield should do wonders for the Bobcats this year and probably get them better than a 6-6 record.
Yeah, that was one thing. You know, like you were saying, we have run with smaller receivers in the past, but I mean, you can't coach size. Yeah. You've got Miller, who's 6'5", Ijah, and who am I looking for?
Who's Gunter.
Gunter. They're 6'3". I mean, those are huge targets. And then with the running backs, I'm kind of curious how Fran is going to split it between the three of them. Maybe just go with the hot hand. But they're all three. They're solid running backs. So I mean, you can't really go wrong. But hopefully this year we get a little bit better health out of our offensive line. I felt kind of towards the end of the season, the offensive line, they're kind of dropping like flies. So I think that hurt the running game a little bit. So I think if the offensive line can stay healthy, the running game it'll be strong.
Yeah, offensive line, again, they were young last year
definitely.
As well with
Cohesion,
Tyler Jones.
Another
and
year
all of that.
Under the belt.
Another year, another spring underneath the belt.
Yeah.
You know, as much as we love offense, defenses win championships.
And we got a little change in the defense.
You know, I know they gave up 30 and 29 points, but I talked to Coach Washington, and he had a few interesting things to say.
Yeah.
Coach Washington here, secondary coach. Coach, Saturday you played a spring game. Gold team wins 30 to 29. How do you feel about that result?
It was exciting. Unfortunately, I was on the maroon team, and I wish we could have held on to the lead and pulled that thing off. But overall, it was fun. It was fun to see the excitement between both teams and the competition, and I thought it was a good atmosphere.
Now, Coach, usually in spring games, defense is ahead of the curve, and they gave up 30 points and 29 points. What's going on with the defense there?
I think we threw out some wrinkles, and, you know, you had some guys playing with some other guys that sometimes are unfamiliar with. But, you know, offensively, they made some big plays, and those things kind of happen. But overall, like I said, those guys played hard, and it was an exciting game and great atmosphere.
Now, Coach, I know you're going more in the secondary, and Coach Thompson is coming in here with somewhat of a different scheme, but it's kind of similar to what he ran in Arkansas State. How do you think the players are adjusting to the new scheme and the new fit?
I think they've done a good job just buying in and understanding the scheme and the terminology. Coach Thompson's been great just implementing his scheme and new defensive mentality. And so the guys have been great. They've hit the road running and have done a good job of understanding what needs to be done with the defense scheme.
I talked to Coach Conway earlier, and we talked about the schedule a little bit. You know, you're going to play Tulsa, you're going to play Navy, Illinois, then you're going to play Arkansas State, Lafayette. I mean, it's a gauntlet. What do you expect from this defense this year around after they went through it last year?
Definitely. We definitely have to continue what we started from the previous years. You know, we made steps forward. We just got to continue to do that, of being physical, playing sound ball, playing hard for four quarters. And if we're able to do that, you know, I think we got a chance.
Thank you so much, Coach Washington. Really appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Coach Washington, he's always fun to talk to.
He's always happy, man.
Yeah, he's a blast. Always has a smile on his face. Unfortunately, he was part of the losing team, being on the maroon squad. But he said that he loved the competition that he saw. He saw that they were competing at a high level. And I think that should be interesting for the defense because, you know, last year, number one rushing defense in the conference. They should be able to build on that with Arakpo coming and David Mayo. Going to be young in the secondary a little bit, but I don't think that should hinder their progress at all. But the biggest storyline is that they have a new defensive coordinator in John Thompson. Greg Naver leaves to go to Kentucky to be the special teams coach and the secondary coach. John Thompson comes in from Arkansas State, kind of implementing his system. And we even talked to Coach Washington off camera talking about the different systems and different looks that they're going to be giving this year. It's going to be fun to watch a Bobcat defense.
Yeah, definitely. You know, they did. They gave up 30 and 29 points on both sides, gave up, you know, a good amount of yards. But like Coach Washington was saying, was, you know, they weren't too focused about keeping them down in the points. You know, it's a spring game. They're going to score points. But his biggest thing was the guys understanding the terminology and just being comfortable in the system. You know, he was saying, you know, they've cut down on the terminology and a lot of calls just to let the guys just feel free, go get the ball and make plays. So I definitely feel like, you know, there's going to be good things out of this defense as soon as they, you know, I feel like they're getting a better understanding of it. So once it starts clicking, you know, once the season starts, I feel like they'll be good to go.
Yeah, I definitely agree. Getting three key turnovers, Brix Hawthorne, for those of you that missed it, the one-handed interception he had of Tyler Jones was amazing. He just came out, just threw one arm up, took the ball, just went 84 yards. And Tyler Jones, who's a pretty fast athlete himself, could not catch up to Brix. And so that was really interesting. They were able to get a fumble off Fred Nixon. fumbled on a zone option read. So that was really cool. And then another interception happened as well. So definitely it looks like there's going to be an opportunistic defense this year.
That's kind of what I was thinking about the Saints defense when they won the Super Bowl.
Definitely.
You know, led the league in turnovers. You know, they weren't the best. You know, they were kind of like a bend but don't break defense. They give up a lot of yards. I kind of feel like, you know, if we're opportunistic, get a lot of turnovers, interceptions, force the fumble, sack the quarterback, give our offense a chance to get the ball back. Because I think our offense is going to be great. So I think that's what our defense really needs to focus on, is turning the football over.
I completely agree. I know John Thompson, when he was there at Arkansas State, you know, they always had a top five defense in the Sun Belt. So that should translate over. And they have a good building block. Yeah. You know, you're going to have Michael Odiari back, Kingsley Ike, who couldn't play last year. He's going to be back. Then, of course, you have Arakpo and Mayo. And then you have Greg Mager out in secondary, who a lot of people think that could have gotten drafted this year as a junior. So he comes back for a senior season. Hopefully he can build on the success he had last year. You have David Mims as well. So this defense, there's a lot to look forward to, and the game seems like it's more simplified for them, so it looks like they shouldn't be doing a lot of thinking. They should just be playing.
Yeah, I mean, I think the run defense is going to be strong again this year, especially with our linebacking core. But I think it's just a lot with the secondary. Let's see how they grow up and see if they can, you know, really start making plays. You know, Craig Mager, you know, that guy's a monster. I think he's going to be really solid for the Bobcats this year.
Yeah, I definitely agree. There's a lot to look forward to in Texas State football. Oh, yeah. And then really, you know, everyone on campus should be really excited. 6-6 last year, being bowl eligible for the first time in school history, looking to do the same again this next coming season. A team that maybe expectations were a little bit too high for this year is the Texas State baseball team. They lose to UTSA Tuesday night 7-2, giving up a 2-1 lead.
Yeah, 6 runs in the 8th.
You know, so we have a lot to talk about. Yeah. But before we talk about Texas State baseball, take one quick break and hear a word from our sponsors.
We've done it. Since opening last fall, Vapor Essentials has provided San Marcos with the best in electronic cigarettes. Whether you're kicking the smoking habit or interested in the growing popularity of vaping, there's never been a better time to visit. Vaporize and customize with our ever-expanding inventory. All 100% authentic hardware from brands like Totally Wicked, Halo, and more. We also carry the best quality e-liquid by Texas Select Vapor, with nicotine ranges from 0 to 24. Try before you buy, or just kick back at our full-service vaping bar. Our friendly and experienced staff will help you with all your vaping needs. Whether you're new or a familiar face, we'll be happy to provide you with the highest quality of customer service. At Vapor Essentials, we are consumers for consumers. We are your e-cigarette store. Stop by at 1515 Aquarina Springs or call us today at 512-878-8869. 18 and older, we ID.
Hey Bobcats, Otis here. Let's take a minute to talk about the University Bookstore and Fan Shop. These on-campus stores take care of all your Texas State needs, from books and supplies to Bobcat apparel and gifts. And the more you shop, the more these stores can give back to the students and organizations of Texas State. You can find the bookstore at the LBJ Student Center and the Fan Shop at Bobcat Stadium. You can also check them out online at bookstore.txstate.edu. Be sure to mention From the Field to the Fans and the Fan Shop for a 10% discount.
Need cupcakes or cookies for your sweet tooth, or maybe a custom decorated cake for your sorority or fraternity celebration? Pennington's Cakes has you covered. Since 1962, Pennington's Cakes has been providing some of the best tasting desserts in Central Texas. We bake our cakes, cupcakes, and cookies fresh to order with quality ingredients and lots of love and care. No matter the order, Pennington's Cakes will rise to the occasion. Every one of our creations is artfully decorated and memorably presented. Get 10% off your purchase when you show your Texas State ID. We also offer free wedding cake consultations. We're conveniently located at 1662 South I-35, right next to Thad Ziegler Glass. Come by or call us today and join our family of satisfied customers. Our number is 512-396-4059. 512-396-4059.
We're back. for Tyler Hammond. I'm Otis Evergarl. Talk about Texas State baseball. I know we're on the football field right now, but we do like to talk about the other sports here at Texas State. They lose Tuesday night 7-2 to UTSA. I guess UTSA had a little revenge on their mind. Another late inning comeback win. If anyone remembers when they came to San Marcos about 2 weeks ago, Texas State did the same thing to them. So I guess they're trying to return the favor. Getting 6 runs in the bottom of the 8th. Not a good showing for the Bobcats. They dropped to 19-17 now. They've lost 3 straight. It just seems like the focus for the team right now is just not there.
Yeah. One thing I was reading up on beforehand is we struggle on the road. We're 5-11 away from home.
Yeah.
So that's not good. But yeah, I feel like the focus has definitely kind of been gone for a while. You know, I was thinking maybe, you know, we've heard them talk a lot about Omaha. Maybe they need to shift that focus to, you know, one game at a time and really focus on, you know, the opponent on Friday, the opponent on Saturday, Tuesday, you know, and really go look at it one game at a time, you know, not a series, not the whole season, but really, you know, trim that focus down a little bit.
I completely agree. Even the focus on the defensive side, you know, I've read some things and I've seen that this is one of the most talented teams that Ty has had, you know, and it screams volumes when they're 19-17 and, you know, getting 7 errors in a game against Monroe, you followed up with 2, you have another one that costs you against UTSA. I mean, where's the focus on this team? Where's the senior leadership you kind of question at times? Where's Hunter Lemke? You know, he's supposed to be the closer coming in. ERA is high, giving up 2 earned runs, really giving up 6 in the bottom of the 8th. Not a good showing by him.
I kind of feel like Harrington's just kind of pulling straws right now.
Yeah.
You know, he's been tossing the lineup around. He's been tossing the bullpen around, just trying to find a working formula, and I just don't really think he knows where to go. But a little bit of positive note from the weekend. Stuttered, 2 runs, 5 hits, 9 RBIs. Geisler had 5 runs, 9 hits, and 3 RBIs.
Yeah.
You know, the bats were out this weekend, which we've been looking for all season long.
It's a pitching.
Yeah.
You know, Taylor Black pitches 5 innings but gives up 11 runs on 12 hits.
Yeah.
You know, Lucas Humphrey not able to pull it out. You know,
Austin Williams had a decent outing. He went to 5-1. Yeah, he had a decent outing. But I feel like other than Austin Williams, even the bullpen, there just wasn't a whole lot going for the pitching staff today, or this weekend, sorry.
And it's going to be interesting to see how Texas State fares, you know, going down the stretch. They're going to play Western Kentucky this weekend, I believe. No, they're not going to play Western Kentucky. I was looking at Western Kentucky because of softball, excuse me. I believe they're going to play Georgia State this weekend, if I remember correctly. And Georgia State, they're 5-10 in the conference. They've lost 2 straight. They're 17-20 overall. So hopefully, and it's going to be at home, I believe, as well. So hopefully they can be able to pull it against Georgia State and do work. Because right now, like you said, I think Harrington is looking for continuity and drawing at straws right now.
Yeah, he's, I don't know, I kind of feel bad for him. Like you were saying, this is a really talented team. But they're just nothing's clicking. You know, early on in the season, the pitching was rolling, the sticks weren't there too hot. But this weekend, we had our best offensive output, scored 30 runs over the weekend, but pitching wasn't there, and the defense definitely wasn't there.
Yeah, I think that train was trying to tell us that we're right. That's what the horn was for. If you live in San Marcos, you know you're never going to get away with not hearing the train horn.
It's everywhere. It's everywhere.
Yeah, but, you know, baseball is going to be really interesting. Hopefully they can get it back together. Another team that we're looking to see that can get it back together is a softball team as well. I believe they're 3 games, 4 games underneath 500 right now. They don't have a midweek game this week, but they're going to play Western Kentucky, who's above them in the Sun Belt Conference standings, and they're drawing at straws too as well. Yeah. So we're going to try to figure out what straws they're trying to pick out. But before we do that, we're going to take one final break and hear a word from our sponsors.
We've done it. Since opening last fall, Vapor Essentials has provided San Marcos with the best in electronic cigarettes. Whether you're kicking the smoking habit or interested in the growing popularity of vaping, there's never been a better time to visit. Vaporize and customize with our ever-expanding inventory. All 100% authentic hardware from brands like Totally Wicked, Halo, and more. We also carry the best quality e-liquid by Texas Select Vapor, with nicotine ranges from 0 to 24. Try before you buy or just kick back at our full-service vaping bar. Our friendly and experienced staff will help you with all your vaping needs. Whether you're new or a familiar face, we'll be happy to provide you with the highest quality of customer service. At Vapor Essentials, we are consumers for consumers. We are your e-cigarette store. Stop by at 1515 Aquarina Springs or call us today at 512-878-8869. 18 and older, we ID.
Hey Bobcats, Otis here. Let's take a minute to talk about the University Bookstore and Fan Shop. These on-campus stores take care of all your Texas State needs, from books and supplies to Bobcat apparel and gifts. And the more you shop, the more these stores can give back to the students and organizations of Texas State. You can find the bookstore at the LBJ Student Center and the Fan Shop at Bobcat Stadium. You can also check them out online at bookstore.txstate.edu. Be sure to mention From the Field to the Fans and the Fan Shop for a 10% discount.
Need cupcakes or cookies for your sweet tooth, or maybe a custom decorated cake for your sorority or fraternity celebration? Pennington's Cakes has you covered. Since 1962, Pennington's Cakes has been providing some of the best tasting desserts in Central Texas. We bake our cakes, cupcakes, and cookies fresh to order with quality ingredients and lots of love and care. No matter the order, Pennington's Cakes will rise to the occasion. Every one of our creations is artfully decorated and memorably presented. Get 10% off your purchase when you show your Texas State ID. We also offer free wedding cake consultations. We're conveniently located at 1662 South I-35, right next to Thad Ziegler Glass. Come by or call us today and join our family of satisfied customers. Our number is 512-396-4059. 512-396-4059.
And we're back here to talk about some Texas State softball. It's a rough weekend. Not being able to win on the road. They're 0-12 this season. The mentality and the focus there, you know, you got to question that as well. Not being able to win a game on the road, it's got to be very disappointing to Ricky. It's got to be disappointing to some of the players on the team.
Yeah, the pitching got tattooed this weekend.
Yeah.
It was not. Rainhouse, you know, first game she threw was not her best outing. And then Ashley Wright threw on, I believe, the second game on Saturday. It just was not a good outing. And I think it was Georgia State that they played.
Yeah, Georgia
they're,
State.
They're putting up runs every single inning, so it's kind of hard for your, you know, if your offense isn't doing too well to, you know, stick up with them and, you know, put runs on the board every inning and follow up the opponent.
Yeah, and Georgia State, they had a couple of pitchers there that were really good. Caitlin Medlem, I believe, she got two victories over the weekend over the Bobcats. And, you know, I just, Rainhouse, you got to kind of question a little bit mentality, you know, mentally. I don't know if she's tired. You know, she's 18. She has 18 wins, but I think it's 15 losses 15? Now. I think it's 14 or 15 losses. So, you know, she's played a lot of games, consider the games that she's been a relief pitcher in as well. So, you know, you got to question that. They were off to the best start they've had in 10 years. You know, they beat number 23 Cal, and you know the talent is there because they beat South Alabama, who was number 11 in the country. Took two out of three against them. So definitely the talent's there. In fall ball, they were undefeated. They go 8-0. You're keeping up with the Baylors of the world, you know, losing to them by one run. You know, so you got to figure sometimes where is this talent going and where, you know, where's the focus at?
I feel like it's a lot like the baseball team. You know, their consistency. That's the key issue. They just haven't been consistent at all this season. But I feel like with Rainhouse, I think she might just be mentally exhausted.
Yeah.
You know, if you know there's nobody on the pitching staff other than you that can come and pick you up, you think it, you know, you have this feeling that it's all on your shoulders and you have to go out there and try to pitch your best game every single game, pitch your best inning every time you go out there. And, I mean, that's not possible.
No.
So I feel like she just might be mentally exhausted. And coach just – I feel like she just doesn't have confidence in any of the other pitchers on the staff.
Yeah, I completely agree with you. It's hard, too. You know, Ashley Wright, who pitched a decent game this weekend, too, as well. You know, you try to bank on her, but she's Jekyll and Hyde. Mm-hmm. You know, you don't know what you're going to get when she's on the mound.
She gave up – I think it was 7 runs in the first inning, then cruised through the rest of the game.
You know, it's almost like, you know, you get past the first inning with Ashley Wright. And that's been the MO for Ashley even last year. It was, man, first inning, you give up 4 or 5 runs, and – 2 through 7, you're just
solid.
Like
where
all
America,
like you know, all conference. You know, so it's going to be interesting to see. You know, they're going to play Western Kentucky, who's above them in the conference standings, and Texas State. Now, there's no more getting swept. They can't lose series. They've got to start. Yeah. They got to win the midweek games against some of these tougher guys, and they've got to start winning series 2 out of 3, or start sweeping them because they got a lot of ground to make up. You know, you have Lafayette, who's 11-1 in the conference. You're going to have South Alabama, who's still tough.
Ranked,
Western Kentucky.
It's a tough end
Georgia
of the schedule.
Georgia State.
Tough end
know,
of the schedule.
So hopefully they'll be able to pull it together.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is, you know, the pitching staff, it's Rainhouse.
Yeah.
I feel like the bats really need to step up. We only scored 5 runs this weekend.
Right.
So the offense needs to understand, you know, the pitching. If the pitching struggles, we have to put some runs on the board. We need to get people on base. So I don't know if coach needs to, you know, tinker with the lineup, move people around to try to get some people on base. I mean, I don't play some small ball. I don't know, something to get some people on base, start moving runners around and get some runs across the board to help out these pitchers.
Yeah, and the combo of Tamisha North, Kelly Baker, and Courtney Harris up top, the top three. You know, at one point they had 48% of the Bobcats hits just from those three women alone. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you got to find productivity from somewhere else.
Down
and hopefully, they can, you know, it can start getting together. You know, you got to start questioning a little bit Coralie Ramirez. Mm-hmm. She's a senior. Jordan Masick is a senior. Courtney Crowell has 7 home runs, but, you know, if she's not letting the long ball, she's grounding out or getting out. So, you know, it's got to be continuity to the lineup, and hopefully they'll be able to find that.
Yeah, I mean, it's – coach is going to have to find some magic or something. Yeah. She's going to have to figure something out. I don't really know what she can do, but – she just needs to find a good group that can go out there, put together some runs, you know, a solid pitcher. I think they'll bounce back a little bit this week. And I think, Coach, I think you said that they don't have a weak game.
Don't have a midweek
game. I think that'll help a little bit, give them some rest, kind of get this weekend out of their head.
Yeah, definitely. And I hope, they don't want to make it back-to-back losing seasons. No. You know, last year was like the second time in like 14 years that Ricky's
long
been
time.
Here that she's had a losing season, so hopefully, you know, that doesn't happen. But before we skedaddle, you gotta give me a final thought.
My final thought, I was looking at this morning, the women's golf team is in second, right? Well, going into today, they were in second, 6 shots back of the Sunbelt Women's Championship. Yeah. Shout out to the Bobcat women in golf.
Yeah, they're doing really well. The Poussai, Luthway, you know, they Coach Akers has a good squad there. It's unfortunate we don't talk about them enough. Women's golf, men's golf, they did decently to this season a little bit. I know they struggle at sometimes, but, you know, hopefully they'll do well. And men in track and field, we'll talk about them a little bit too as well in the future. You know, Coach Boone's always got a good squad out there. Darian Brown right now, he is throwing lights out right now. So that's going to be fun. But right now, my final thoughts is, you know, a little national here. NBA playoffs is here. Everyone's set up. You're kind of still looking for the seeding there. The East, no one's going to watch. But the West, I think
it's going
to
be crazy.
From game one to the last game of the Western Conference Finals, I got to watch every game.
It's a toss-up.
You just don't know who's coming out of the West.
Well, I think there's only two seed. I think the 4-5 is the only one in the West that's set.
I think San Antonio is set as well. I think the top four.
I was hearing on my way up here, they said the Clippers could still snag the two if the Thunder lose tonight.
Okay.
But I don't think Blake Griffin and someone else isn't. I think J.J. Redick
isn't playing.
One of them are playing tonight. So who knows? Tonight will be a good night. Everything may completely flip-flop.
Yeah. We're from Houston, so we're biased. So we're go Rockets.
Actually, speaking of Houston, I don't know if you saw George Springer got his call up.
Yes, he did.
He's finally.
Yes,
it's about time.
I don't know what took them so long. The offense was struggling. At one point, they were hitting a collective 188. So George Springer, I think I saw like a picture of a poster of him that was kind of like the Obama colors, and then hope on the bottom. Yes,
We hope.
You are a hope, George Springer. But, you know, that's it from beautiful Bobcat Stadium for Tyler Hammond. I am Otis Sevigal, and like I always say, we'll see you next time. Bye.